In 2019, the European Union threatened to ban Uganda's agro exports to Europe. The cause was chemical contamination of horticulture produce being exported by farmers, which the international market deemed hazardous.
We're getting to realize that so many countries, even our own neighboring countries, are rejecting most of the food that we're trying to export, such as maize, because of the aflatoxins that have affected their product, even just trading with one another. But also the challenges that come about when it's to do with how we monitor the value chain, when it comes straight from the inputs.
The latest is maize with aflatoxins that was recently impounded en route to South Sudan market. It is such persistent occurrences that threaten our export destinations.
The value addition that is made in those products, the post-harvesting and harvesting, and even when before they even reach onto the shelves, the issue of counterfeit products has continued to emerge, and there has been a limiting coherence with the government to ensure that these products are actually put off in terms of when it comes to even their way of intervening with these businesses that try to market their products. There should be a way for government to strengthen their enforcement on standards, but also when it comes to how they're able to look at the population that is even taking these products in.
According to Uganda Bureau of Statistics, 80% of Uganda's total exports consists of agricultural products, with the most important commodity being coffee, followed by tea, cotton, copper, oil and fish. So, what should be done to improve the quality of products exported? Decentralization of food safety laboratories to ease conformity of standards has been identified as an immediate solution to monitor what is exported.